And we'll talk to
Paolo. The president has arrived in Davao City at around 10:30 on his way to visit typhoon survivors. Let's talk to Communications Secretary Ricky Carandang. He is with the president. Secretary Carandang, good morning, sir.
Good morning, thank you.
All right, so Secretary, you are in Davao right now, Davao City.
That's right. We've just arrived, as you said, at about 10:30, mm-hmm. and we're now off to visit about three municipalities in Davao Oriental, three municipalities that have been hit by the storm. To inspect these areas, to see how the people here are doing, the victims are doing, to see whether or not the operations for relief and rescue are proceeding as planned, as he normally does when things like this happen. So he's about to enter the chopper to go to the first area.
I'm sorry, can you repeat that, Secretary? The president is?
He's entering the chopper now to go to the first municipality.
All right. All cabinet secretaries are going to be with him, sir, because I know a number of you are there with him, maybe about eight of you?
It's about 11 of us, Pinky.
Okay.
There are about five choppers, including the security.
Mm-hmm.
The cabinet members will be with the president, for example. Rojas, Abaya, and the others. There are a few of us who are going to remain here in Davao Airport to continue to brief the media and to deal with some of the local government officials.
Mm-hmm.
So among those who, everyone is actually going with the president except for Secretary De Lima, myself, Luistro, and Antonino.
I see.
So the rest of them are going. With the president.
All right. Secretary, the vice president has visited these areas. DILG Secretary Mar Rojas has also visited the area. This came also today's visit, of course, planned by the president to visit the typhoon-hit areas in Davao Oriental and, of course, in Comval or Compostela Valley. What else can we expect, Secretary, from the fact that the president will do to look into the situation and find out what needs to be done? But immediately, has there been any word on possible short-term plans for the area?
Well, there will be everything that has been prepared for is already happening. The relief goods are being distributed. We want to see how the people are coping with it right now in the relief centers. There are some issues that have come up, which we will discuss at mm-hmm. more length later this afternoon. Thank you. Once the president is finished with his site inspections, he's coming back here to the Davao International Airport, where he will be briefed by the NDRRMC and local government officials. And there you'll hear about some of the concerns of the president. As you know, we were very determined to keep the casualty rate relatively low compared to Sendong. And while it's still low relative to Sendong last year, it is something that is of a concern. There's over 300 people who have been mm-hmm. confirmed to have been killed. And, of course, the president is deeply concerned about the number of yeah. casualties.
Right. I know the president had said that even one death is one too many. Secretary, as on a last note, you said some issues need to be discussed. DENR Secretary Ramon Pahe is also going to be with the president. Is that also going to top the agenda on what needs to be done regarding mining or no mining, small-scale mining, where it is allowed, what happened to our mountains, etc.?
Well, it's not so much that as questions about whether or not the rescue operations went properly, what contributed. You're right, not necessarily mining, but there's reports about small-scale mining, there's reports about logging that might have exacerbated the situation. So all of this will be discussed. But the bottom line for the president, Pinky, as you correctly said, he said before that even one life lost is one life too much. And he wants to know, despite the fact that everything seems to have been done properly, he wants to know if anything more could have been done to prevent the number of casualties.
Yes. All right, Secretary Ricky Carandang, sir, thank you so much for taking our call.
Thank you, Pinky.
All right, let's go back to Paolo.
All right, thank you.